Having a hard time with love lasting long enough? How often is your first date your last date? Have you noticed that your relationships last no more than 2 days? They say love never lasts, but in your case, it doesn't even start. Your birthday is a secret soul security number. We know everything about you, how you love, how you lust, and how you like to be lusted by. In one video, you'll understand what you're looking for in love and what you offer. Secrets of Birthdays, now available at secretsofbirthdays.com. Hello, Captain. Welcome back from the weekend, and thank you for logging in. Well, cloudy nesting and resting today for the goats. The moon is well into Aries, shifting emotional focus to your well-being and your groundedness. Also, your self-mothering and your self-nurturing. Now, yesterday on Sunday, the moon crossed Jupiter and Uranus now in Aries. I'll get more on Jupiter in just a second, which means in the last 24 hours, you might have had a minor little earthquake, spiritual earthquake, where you felt unsettled, not grounded. Maybe you needed to be nurtured. Maybe you're seeking your mommy, which is a need for nurturing, okay? So today is kind of the follow through of that, and really what your soul needs emotionally is to ground and to kind of reassess your home family situation, hopefully for the better. Now, let me zip over to the sun first. The sun is in Gemini, as you all know, in chapter 2, and today ruled by Neptune, which means today we're all intuitive. Today's a day of receiving information, connecting to our higher self, basically integrating our subconscious awareness with our conscious awareness. And for you, this is all centered around your lifestyle in the moment. So I think today what the lesson is how you feel in the moment. Are you feeling at peace? Can you maintain a sense of peace? Can you maintain a sense of balance and order in your life? And if so, why not? Today's a great day to meditate on why not. What threw you off track? What threw your moment off track? What's distracting you? What's in the way? And also, maybe starting to contemplate at this point on what would a daily moment be like in the perfect world, which is what we're here to manifest, is our perfect world. Now back to Jupiter. Jupiter has moved into Aries as of Sunday. Jupiter in Aries is a big deal. Jupiter's our expansion vibration. It also is where fortune shows up in our life. But when it first arrives on the scene of a given house or area of our consciousness, it puts a lot of pressure for us to grow. So, for you, Jupiter in Aries means that in the next year, you will be expanding your footprint. You'll be expanding how well you ground yourself. You'll be expanding your self-nurturing. You'll be expanding your home. You might be expanding your family. But in this early stage of Jupiter, it may feel like everything is too close for comfort, that you don't have a big enough home or enough self-nurturing, etc. So if you're feeling that anxiety, it is a call to expand, and Jupiter will be calling for some time. And it's Monday. That means we have Julie Zipper calling today with Meditation Vibration. She's got her Chapter 3 episode of Gemini online. And since Neptune rules the day, perfect day to actually watch Julie, sit at your desk, sit anywhere you are, and just do this 5-minute meditation with her. Actually, it's 3 minutes, the guided meditation. Let her bring you along this path and see what comes to you. Julie is live everywhere in the garden. All right, Capricorn, that wraps up the start of this week. Tomorrow we're back to talk about Mars moving into Virgo. I don't know what that was. Until then, live, love, be. So good.